Dear student, today we will discuss database architectures. My name is Bilal Khan. When we say that database architectures, it is very important to understand the architecture of database very well. What's the reason behind that? Reason is that what are those different database levels where we can see the data in a database, and to make the proper use of the database, to design the database properly, we have to understand the architectures of the database. That's why it is very necessary to understand the architectures of database. To design the database, to handle the database, to store the database, we need to understand. It is very necessary to understand the architecture of database. Before discussing the current architectures, we will discuss the concept of history of the database architectures. At the beginning, there was a traditional file processing systems. And traditional file processing system was introduced to store the data, to manipulate the data, to perform different operation with the data. But when what was the problem with the traditional file processing systems? When there was one moon landing project, the name of that one project was Applo Moon Landing Project, that generated a massive amount of the data, large volume of the data. To handle that one data, there was no systems to deal with it. Then, to overcome the problems, first DBMS was introduced. The name of that DBMS is a database management system was introduced. The name of that database system was IMS, Information Management Systems. When this IMS, Information Management System, was implemented, that was the first database systems. Information management system was based on hierarchical data model. From its name, very clear that we see that hierarchical data model. In this one model, we are having the tree like structures. We are having the parent entity, then we are having the child. One parent may have the many child, but one child belongs to only one parent. So it supports one-to-one relationship, one-to-many relationship, but it doesn't deal many-to-many relationship. Moreover, one drawback in this one system, that information management system deal one-to-one relationship, one-to-many relationship, but many-to-many relationships are not supported by the information management systems. Secondly, people start finding it hard to implement the different applications and different situations using the information management system or hierarchical data models. So after that one, the new system was introduced. They provided a new solution for that one, and that was IDS, Integrated Data Store. Integrated Data Store was implemented. When we see that Integrated Data Store was implemented, this one was based on the network data models. Network data models, we are having one networks having the different type of the connections over here. Let me draw it. We are having this one, then having the relationships. We are having one to many relationships. This one is connected with this one. I am just using these, having the relationship, one to many relationships. So this one system was integrated data models. It supports one to one relationship, one to many relationship, as well as many-to-many relationship. But if they have to modify the systems, they have to start make it from scratch, re-implement it from the scratch. When IDS systems were not working properly, then after that one effort was made to standardize the architecture of the database. So to standardize the architecture of the database, there was one conference. The name of that one conference was CODASEL, Conference of Data System and Language Committee. This one appointed DBTG. So what was the DBTG? Database Task Group. Conference on the Data System and Language Committee appointed one task group. The name of that task group was DBTG, to make effort to standardize the database architectures. So what was the responsibility of DBTG? To standardize the architecture of the database. For that one, in 1971, DBTG proposed the two-level architectures. When DBTG proposed the two-level architectures, in this one architectures, there was a two different level was there. One is system view, that is called schema. Second one is a user view, that is called sub schema. What is the schema or system view? To represent the view of whole organization's database structures. To represent the complete structure of whole of the organizations, they introduce the concept of the system view. Second one, that was related to the user view, to represent the view of the different user group, that how the different user can view the data. Data was there, how different user can view same data differently. So that was a two-level architecture that contains system view or user view. System view contains the, that is called schema. Mean collection of the different database objects are combined over there, that provide to represent the whole of the organization's structure. User view, sub schema. To define the system view and user view, DDL was used, data definition language was used, that defined the system view and user view, or schema and sub schema. After that one, there was one organization, the name of that one is ANSI. ANSI reject the recommendation of database task group, and ANSI organized one committee. The name of that one committee was SPARC, Standard Planning and Recruitment Committee. Standard Planning and Recruitment Committee to suggest the architecture of database. So SPARC proposed the three-level architectures. So in next video, we will discuss that what was the three-level architecture and what are the benefits of the three-level architectures.